I want to know, Manny, if you could whip up some chocolatey science for us.
Yeah, definitely, man.
All right.
So right here, we've got a little bit of cocoa powder.
Okay.
See what you use to make hot chocolate, all them things there?
Mm.
Now, the thing about cocoa powder is that it's hydrophobic.
Hydrophobic, what does that mean?
So that means that it repels water, so it won't get wet, basically.
It won't get wet?
Yeah.
That doesn't make any sense.
We're going to demonstrate it right now.
I don't believe you. I don't believe me, man. Should we do it together?
Yeah, let's do it together.
All right, count this in, everyone. Yes. Three, two, one.
Go.
So I'm just... Oh, yeah, it looks...
Okay.
Hang on.
Now what we do... You see that?
You got a little...
You just poke it there.
Oh, yeah!
You see it's still dry underneath.
So wait, I don't understand the science of how that works. What's making that happen?
Okay, so do you remember before when I told you that water has a negative and a positive charge?
Yeah.
Right, so the cocoa powder, it doesn't have any charge whatsoever. So that's why it repels the water.
Okay, I see. Now, that basically means that it's not charged, it repels it.
Yeah, exactly.
I see, it doesn't attract the water. But yeah, would it work on a bigger scale? Because I know the people at home right now, they'll want to try it. But we're here in the BP studio, so I think we should just rank it up a bit, go bigger.
Yeah, man, let's do it big, man.
Should we try it?
Yeah, man, right here, we've got a massive spoon of
cocoa powder. Now we're talking, come on.
Yeah.
This is... Yeah, look at that. You can make a lot of hot chocolate with that.
Yeah.
Should we do it again?
Yeah, man, let's dunk it.
All right, let's go.
Let's do it.
Three, two, one.
Go.
Hang on. Ah, mine's still dry.
Still dry.
Wait. That is magic. Can we get that on a slow-mo? I want to see that again. That looks so cool.
What just happened?
Look. But it stays. That's completely dry.
Still dry.